Hello, everyone. Thanks for coming. Let me just briefly introduce Philippe Jan and the Pulsar team. So the Android Developer Relations team, which I'm on, we met Philippe at Mobile World Congress back in Barcelona in February. And that was when we first heard about Philippe's kind of indoor location technology. And we were obviously really excited about it. And so, you know, things have happened, over the past couple months. And now Philippe and Jan are here to talk about their technology. So with that, Jan, take it away.
Thanks, Roman, for the introduction. And thanks, everyone, for being here today. So the topic of the day is called NAO Campus. That's the name of our technology. And as the title say, we're going to show you it's actually ready and ready for market and probably something you want to hear about and use. So brief agenda of what it's going to be about. We do a quick introduction, and then we jump straight into what it looks like, how it actually works. We get a bit into details about how you could interface with it in terms of software interfaces and so on and so forth. Give you a few background details about why we think it's a good technology, and then we'll open it up for Q&As and let you guys fire away as much as you want. Okay, so let's start with the only bit that is not going to be technology related, which is why would you want indoor positioning? Indoor location has been talked about a great deal, but here we're talking about a real need that we are hearing from customers, especially in Europe, but also here as well. And they really talk about critical use cases, like in big buildings, being able to orient themselves and leverage the signaling potential problems and so on and so forth. And this is real life stuff. It's no longer PowerPoint, although you see it right now, but I'm going to show you further and better things later. It goes further than that. So the typical use cases we're looking at on our side, and we hope you guys will be excited about, is how about you're at the airport and you want to move around, you've got a little time between flights. What's the best place for you to go? How do you cut it out? And how do you make sure you actually catch your plane and leave it on time? So that's typical standard stuff. And the thing we're really deeply looking into is malls. So commercial malls, we hear a lot about from their owners who are keen on actually getting a closer relationship to their customers. Making sure they get leads about what they are interested in and how to make sure they do some buyout and so on and so forth. And from the users or the mall visitors as they're concerned, it's again orientation and getting around quickly. So without further ado, let's jump into something that is real. What you're going to see is a quick recording of what we call a demo. It's really NAO Campus running live in a mall somewhere in the United States. I'm not going to be able to really tell you where it is. And we start with another use case that's been proven by applications available on the Android market, which is, where can I get the restrooms? So let me pose that right away. Over there, you have a restroom site. And again, you're in a mall right now. So we're going to switch out to your typical Android phone. Running NAO Campus, you can see the position over there. We are walking around in a position updates, and we're going to go up to the restrooms on the right-hand side here. There we go. So you can see it's being pretty accurate, I would say. We've got probably in the order of 2 to 3 meters accuracy here. And again, this is live running on the phone, so it's no longer just... There's PowerPoint, that's real stuff. So let's get it out about what it brings, what the results we've got from our technology are. So the first thing is real accurate positioning with a high refresh rate. I don't know if you noticed that. So let's check about another quick movie about that. So again, we're still in the mall. We're walking through another place. You can see that we're following where we are and walking around. By the way, this is just demo application. It's not really meant to be an application. Application developers for us are customers. And here, so we are really indoors. So that means we're essentially using the Wi-Fi signals to do this. And so we turn around, it's at the corner where we turn, and there you go. It's just tracking your every move, isn't it? Okay. The other thing we're interested in is it's indoors, and one of the main constituents of an indoor building is floors. But just as we have floors, we want to transition between them. So let me show you that we actually do that. So the position is over there in case you're not seeing it clearly on the video. So this is, again, in a mall. We're taking the elevator slowly up. Everything is running in real time. So CPU is not overloaded. We've got great smooth transitions to the next floors. Just about now, I think. Yeah, here we go. All right. So let me pause there. So that's one of the things we want to offer you guys. And again, that's a result that's no longer just talking. This is what the technology does. The next thing is, okay, what about going out of the building or going in the building? Well, that actually works. So when you're starting from, let's say, a passersby way just out of the building, you're walking around, getting inside the building, you have a seamless transition from outside to inside. Here. It matters to us a lot because it, again, it's tracking seamlessly, and we'll talk about that a little bit in technology-wise stuff. Okay? So before we, we've got a GPS expertise background overall. And before we set out for choosing Wi-Fi as a technology for NAO Campus, we just looked around and saw what's available. And here are the decision criteria we use to choose Wi-Fi. And we hope they make sense to you as well. The first is it's got an absolute penetration. What we mean by that is it's present on all handsets for which we need applications to be downloadable. And that includes 100% of Android handsets. There are other technologies that are available there, but if you talk about UWB, RFID, and stuff like that, it didn't fit that category that we needed. And the next part is, of course, you have a highly available infrastructure with network operators trying to go around saturation in the cellular bands. They deploy Wi-Fi everywhere. And so that's a trend that's going to stay for some time. The next thing that mattered a lot is this is still free bands. It's standard technology already available. So that really means you just use the standard Wi-Fi chip, no modification. It's only software that's running inside. So say if we wanted to leverage our GPS knowledge using GPS positioning with pseudolites, we couldn't do that without modifying the hardware. So that was a problem that we circumvented by using Wi-Fi. And the last thing, again, is you saw it's continuous positioning. So it's not like you go to one place, check in, and then you move to another place, tick, and then you get positioned only on those places. No, it's following you all the way through. Okay, so how does it work? Really, overall, it's a hybridization of GPS, Wi-Fi, and also maps processing, I would say. What we really do is, yes, it's about triangulation. That's a good way to see it. But in details, it's about fingerprinting places. And we've got, research team did a good job at implementing the proper algorithms, which use statistics, motion modelers, and so on and so forth, that are applied to Wi-Fi especially in order to get you this result. And the main point I want to assess now is not only does it use Wi-Fi, but you can go into places like malls where we've seen you don't need to deploy any new access point to get accurate positioning. So the movies you saw were done without adding any hardware to the place we went. We just had the phone, scan, use software, and you had the positioning. So one more set of characteristics. NAO Campus is fully running on board right now. So that means we've got onboard calculations. We've got what we call an onboard database about the site where you do this. And it's, as you see, it's not using too much CPU either. So what's interesting is, it goes quickly and smoothly. throughout every second if you want it to go every second. And if we're coming back to integrating it with your application, what we're going to propose right now is a library that you can integrate within your app directly. And the way you do that is really you use a service interface. I'm sure everyone in the audience knows service interface. So we'll jump in right to where we talk about the fact that we have our specific interfaces. So you just bind to it with an auto-create, as you probably do with most of those interfaces. And the next thing you want to do is your register client. So we've got our own specific AIDL class that's called INAO Location Service. That's the one you guys will want to register to. And to do that, you implement an INAO Location Listener. Sounds pretty like standard stuff, doesn't it? And you're going to get two calls back to get your information out of NAO Campus. The first one is on location changed with a location object. Yes, this is an OS Android location object, standard stuff. So it has WGS84 information with latitude, longitude, and also altitude. So the way we map the floors is we do this in absolute altitude. So, I mean, mean sea level altitude. And the next one you have is on status change, which is just like for any location provider, telling you whether we're out of coverage, in coverage, or maybe temporarily unavailable. So if you find any resemblance to an actual location provider, yes, this is intended. We just wanted to hope for some of you guys to say at some point that you want to have this in Android as a location provider. We'd be glad to do that. And in the meantime, people can still use it just like they would a location provider. And again, I hope you'll have questions on this. Feel free to ask at the end. Okay, the next thing you want to hear about is, okay, so how does this get deployed on a site? We've taken quite some time to develop a pretty good tool suite to allow the deployment of the technology within a site. You can get, on the right-hand side, some nice snapshots. They're actually courtesy of one of our partners, which is the Space Museum in Toulouse called the Cité de l'Espace. They're a museum, and they are kind enough to be in partnership with us, so it's sort of our sandbox for deployment, testing, and also commercial discussions. So the way you deploy the technology is first we'd go around, do a quick diagnostic to see if there's enough Wi-Fi. So that's what we would do in the mall, for instance, to make sure we're doing fine. Also check on the GPS signals if GPS is good enough. You probably don't want to bother with this, but in malls, usually you have to. Then we go around and take the blueprints, usually in an architect format like AutoCAD or things like that, import it into our tool suite, which, by the way, is based on Google SketchUp. And with that, we do some processing of the map to allow to define, say, areas allowed and things like that. And we go around and do a site survey. The way the site survey works is pretty simple. You have your phone. You walk around and tap regularly on waypoints where you've been, and that registers GPS and Wi-Fi information for us to then take it back into the tools, process it, generate the database, and then we get the database on the phone. So that's the simple, basic way of doing deployment on our end. Again, we've got a significant part of the team working on that, and we want to make sure that you guys be happy with this if we come to licensing it to you guys. Okay, going forward, so just to recap, we think it's key for people to know that you can reuse existing Wi-Fi access points in malls and in other public places. It matters a lot because from a business standpoint, obviously, you're not having any cost there. The next part is, this is fully on board, so you don't need any slopiness because you need to connect back to a server or whatever. It's just calculated on the fly here on your phone, and make sure you don't have roaming costs. And the last part is, this is even when we have to deploy, We have low-cost infrastructure because we use standard access points. Again, we use any access point from anybody. And I realized I forgot to mention that we don't connect to Wi-Fi access points in terms of network. We just check that they exist. So it's active scan stuff. Just get the information from the access point exists, and from that do our computation. Okay, so this is a quick slide about where you could see this live. As a matter of fact, we've been, so these are a few pictures of places we've been to. As a matter of fact, we've launched a commercial this year, which means there's a lot about this that I can't disclose in terms of precise places and precise names. But I still want to give you an idea about what's behind those things. So a few things I can talk about. One is we've as far as fairs are concerned, we've been at the CBIT in 2010. And we deployed in a whole navigation floor. So it was a big hall. We had access points on our booth only. And we showed location all around the booth. And as you can guess, it's a fair. So it runs for 3 days. You've got to run, set up stuff quickly, and get it working. So I guess that's proof that our technical team's been doing a good job at being productive and keeping things productive. There's stations I can't really talk about, though they are keen in my heart, to my heart as well. Museums, we've talked about the Citadel's Pass. It's really one place we've been to. And shopping malls, again, I'd love to talk about, but we're going to keep it to ourselves for now. Each of these lines equals one customer at least in my mind, which I cannot speak for. Sorry. And the next segment we're looking into is really industrial sites where we do more, let's say, tracking related things. And also we did a fireman training center, which was pretty interesting. So I guess that tells you the technology is not just here for fun. It's more than a demo. Okay, with this, on the last slide you have our contact details, just in case you don't get your question answered right now. Thank you.